Everybody, and welcome to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I want to share with you guys my entire Robert Tonner and Wild Imagination collection. Now, I didn't decide to do this on a whim. There's actually been an exciting announcement made by Robert Tonner in Virtual Doll Convention this week, and that is that Miss Ellowyn Wild is coming back. And you can order her. She is the Virtual Doll Convention souvenir doll or event doll, I guess we should say, for this March. And you can order Ellowyn through Virtual Doll Convention. So I will leave the links in the description below so you guys can get registered for that convention. I'm actually going to be presenting a program for the convention this time, so I'm really excited about that. I'm excited that Rachel invited me to participate, so thank you very much to her for inviting me to be a part of it. And not only that, but there's a lot of great information through Virtual Doll Convention. I've attended one in the past, and there's such a variety. There's so many different types of dolls, and so there's something for everybody. And so I really encourage you guys to register because it's gonna be a lot of fun, a lot of great information for you guys. But anyway, with that being said, let's go ahead and I'm gonna show you guys my entire Tonner collection. So I'm going to start with the Wild Girls and Boys. This is Evangeline Gastly, and this is the Bad Dream Evangeline. She was a Modern Doll exclusive, and I just love Evangeline. She is like, I don't know what the right word is, but she's just so gothic and so sexy and so gorgeous, and I really love this doll. One day, I really would love to get a resin Evangeline. I thought they were awesome too, and I never did get one because at the time when these dolls were out and available, I actually wasn't in the financial position to buy a lot of dolls, and so I never was able to get one of them, but she is so gorgeous, and I just really love Evangeline and her whole story. Love to get a Parnilla one day, too. That was her friend, but anyway, so that's my Evangeline, but let's move on to the Ellowyn and her pals. Prudence, I'm going to tell you about Prudence. Prudence first. This is Tea and Ennui Prudence, and I got her. She is the first Tonner doll that I ever got, and I have a confession. I actually like Prudence better than Ellowyn. I'm sorry to all the Ellowyn lovers out there. I just love Prudence's face. I think it is so gorgeous. There's something about her face that just draws me in. She's not like a classically gorgeous face, and where Ellowyn is classically gorgeous, and maybe that's what I like. Prudence is more on the cute side, I think. But anyway, my husband bought me Prudence, and Prudence was the first sort of, like, as an adult, like, collectible, expensive, sort of adult-geared doll that I ever got. So I really think that's cool about her. She really, like, kind of broke me into the, you know, upper echelon, I guess you should say, of doll collecting, because up until that time I was just collecting American Girl and vintage vinyl dolls. And so this Prudence really got me started into this journey of, you know, buying more artist dolls and things like that. So that's really cool about her. Now with her, I've got Candlelight Rufus, and I love him because he came out around the time. He's got the pale skin, the dark black hair. You know, he's super gothic. And you know what he reminds me of? He reminds me a lot of Edward from Twilight. He kind of gives me that vibe. Now, I'm not a huge Twilight fan, but I did, you know, watch the movies. I actually read the books too, and I did enjoy it. I'm not like a mega fan, but I enjoyed it. And so I thought it was cool because Rufus is kind of like a little, he's like a little time capsule of a doll because it's at that time period, and he's got to have been influenced by that. And so I think that's so cool. And I love Rufus's face too. Rufus has the most amazing face. I love the sculpt of his face, and it's just so, I just love it. There's just something about it that is so cool. All right, but now let's talk about Ellowyn. This is Over the Top Ellowyn. And Over the Top Ellowyn was an exclusive for the Gone with the Wind event that Robert Tonner did in Atlanta. And that was the first major doll event that I ever went to. And because Atlanta was a day, it's a four-hour drive from me. And so it was the first one I could actually attend. I actually was able to scrape together the funds to go. And it was so exciting. It was just such a cool experience for me. My friend Henny went with me, and we got to meet Robert Tonner. And I was totally starstruck, y'all. I was just like, I mean, he's a celebrity, right? And so when I met him, it was just so exciting. And he was so nice. He actually had a conversation with us. And I was like, you know, it was just the coolest experience ever. And just to go to that, and that started my real love for going to and attending doll events, because it was just such an incredible experience. So here's hoping when things go back to normal, we may see some more Tawner in real life experiences again, because I would love to attend one of those. Also from my wild collection is my Perfectly Patience. So this is Patience, and I love this doll. My husband surprised me with this doll 1 year at Christmas. She was like a totally unexpected gift that I received. And I love her eyes, because her eyes go from side to side, and sometimes she looks really cross-eyed, and it's hilarious. And I just kind of love it, because she looks so ridiculous. But it's so fun. She's got that big head. She's got the eyes that you can, you know, move around. This one is wigged, and you can actually remove the wig if you want to. I've never removed it, but you know, that's really cool to me, because these Tawner dolls were some of the first dolls that I had that were kind of more customizable. And obviously I never customized any of them. They're all in their stock original clothing, but it was just really cool to me to have that option at the time. And I just love these dolls. They're just so beautiful, and they're so much fun. And you know, and I was really glad to get a Patience, because Patience wasn't around for very long. And I think she has a pretty decent cult following, may we say, online. So that is my Patience doll. And then also at the event in Atlanta, he had this sale, and I can't remember what he called it, but there was a sale where there were just piles of dolls on the table in the back, and he would call numbers and you could go look. And I was able to snag a Small World doll. And if you have watched any of my other videos, you know that I love Small World dolls, that I collect Small World dolls. And so I was really glad to be able to get her. This is Small World India. He also did a Holland, which I have not been able to get, but this doll is so cute, and I got her for a really bargain price. I can't remember what it was, but he had all these bargain dolls on the table. So they didn't have boxes or stands or anything, but you know, it was just such a cool experience to participate in that. And you know, I brought her home from that, and so she's really special, not only because she's a Small World doll, but because, you know, of the whole experience and the memories that I have from that event and being able to get her. Next, and I don't know if they're technically, you would consider them Tawner dolls, but these are Tawner Toys dolls. So I've got, this is technically a Pretty Girls doll, Valencia. And beside her, I've got a, oh my gosh, I'm losing the little mismatch. There we go. Sorry, guys. They're produced by Tawner. So they're Tawner toys. They're on the Tawner bodies, and they have Tawner faces. So I imagine there was some sort of partnership between Tawner and Little Mismatched and Pretty Girls that developed these dolls. But I consider them part of my Tawner collection, because he was very much involved with the creation of these dolls. So they're part of my Tawner collection as well. So now I want to show you guys my Harry Potter Tawner collection. So you can see that really my collection consists of Wild Imagination and then licensed Tawner dolls. So that's what I really love. So let's look at the three. So I've got Hermione, and I've got Ron and Harry. And one of the things that was cool about these dolls is they came with interchangeable hands. So they had an extra hand that would hold a wand. And so you can pop that hand out and you can use it with a wand, and then you can change it back to a regular, I guess we can say, relaxed hand. And I just love these dolls. Now he did them in two scales. So he did this scale when they were like young kids, and then he did another scale when they were like older. And so I had a few of the older scales, but I had like a Victor Crumb, and he was huge. But the thing was, is the scaling wasn't right. So I ended up selling those, and I just kept these. And I also got Draco, because there he was. I wish there had been a Luna made in this size. I would love to have had a Luna, but anyway, that's what we've got. And I really, really love those dolls. They're so much fun. And you know, just, you know, I'm a big Harry Potter fan, so I just really wanted these, and you know, what else can I say? They're amazing. The costumes are immaculate. I mean, they have the little button-down shirts inside with the ties. You can see Ron's sloppy as usual with his tie out. And they have wool. I don't know if they're actually wool, but they feel like wool pants and a wool skirt for Hermione. So the attention to detail on these dolls was amazing. And sometimes I still think, I think there was a Lucy doll done from The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. I've thought about trying to get one of her because she's in that size and have her customized maybe to be a Luna, but I don't know if that'd even be possible for me. But anyway, I saw something I've always thought about. And then the last one I got, and this is the last doll that I got before Tawner, the Tawner doll website went down. And this is Newt Scamander. And the attention to detail on this doll is incredible. So look at, he's got his Hufflepuff, he's got his Hufflepuff scarf. He's got, you know, his rich royal blue jacket. Then he's got a blazer, and he's got a vest, and he's got a button-up shirt underneath, and a bow tie. He's got so much detail on him. It's just so amazing. He's got his wand. He's got his briefcase, you know, where all his magical creatures live inside. And so, don't worry, there's no Fantastic Beasts are going to get out of here. But you've got the case, and he's just amazing too. And I was really glad I was able to get him. My mom actually bought him for me for Christmas the year that he came out, so was really excited to get him. Had hoped to see more dolls in this line to fill out the set, because I was kind of always disappointed that I had not started collecting these dolls. Again, because financially I really couldn't, when the Harry Potter series first came out, because I would like to have collected all of them at that time, and I just wasn't able to do so. And so I was really excited about being able to collect the entire Newt Scamander line, or the entire Fantastic Beasts line, I should say. But he's such an incredible doll. I really love him. I just love looking at the details on them. Tawner dolls are really the only dolls I have that I don't change out of their stock outfits much, because with these dolls, I just love their stock. I love the stock on most dolls that I get, but these dolls, the attention to detail is incredible, and they're just such amazing dolls. I really love them so much. But I just wanted to show you guys my entire Tawner collection, and I'm really pumped about Elowen being re-released, and so just really, really excited about that. So guys, I will leave the links below to not only to the virtual doll convention, but to Robert Tawner's Instagram, so you can check the photos there of the new Elowens that are going to be coming out. And if you want to be able to purchase them, make sure you register for virtual doll convention so that you're able to do that. But guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any cool stories about your Tawner dolls, please leave them for me in a comment below, because I'd love to hear them. Let me know which of these is your favorite that I have. I don't know which is my favorite. Probably Prudence, actually. I do know. Prudence is my favorite of all my Tawner dolls. She's, you know, because she was my first, and she's just really special to me in that way. But anyway, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Please subscribe if you're not subscribed, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye. I want to say a big thank you to all of my patrons for supporting this channel. Lindsay S., Leah W., Jenny C., Doreen Z., Janice H., Mercedes W., Angela E., Cindy K., Bear Sunflower, Diane B., Angie E., S.H. Brooks, Lavendea Poupes, Susie W., Hella Clara, Dear Sweet Darlings, Ashley S., and James M. If you guys want to help support this channel, please make sure to check out the description of this video, where I have my Patreon linked. Thank you so much for all of the support.